you're a guy that believes 110% in the product and the service that you provide. You need every weapon in your arsenal. And if that means I know I can get this person to spend more money with me than they would with somebody else because I've got a superior product, I say that's not manipulation, that's obligation.
People buy based on emotions. That's just the way our brains are wired. When you understand this and you develop a sales process that systematically makes an empathetic and emotional connection with your clients, then you will find your closing rate go up. You'll be able to sell your construction services for a higher price than you ever thought imaginable. In fact, you might feel a little guilty about it. You might feel like you're manipulating your customers when you learn how to sell like this. Well, that's what one of my clients, Dustin, felt when he learned how to sell his value and get his customers to spend more money with him. Watch the rest of this video and you'll learn why I believe you are obligated to get your customers to spend more money with you than they would have otherwise. This one's gonna change your life.
Do you ever get hung up morally with stuff like that? Like, I'm actually really good at persuading people, but I almost feel like I'm taking advantage of them when I do it that way. Like I'm manipulating them because I'm really good at it. And so I'm just, it's like, it's a personal crux for me to get over, you know, because I've gotten better at it because I'm like, dang it, you know, you gotta support your family. You gotta put food on the table. You know, I'm not trying to have a lavish lifestyle or be greedy or anything like that. But at the same time, it's like, oh, am I manipulating somebody, you know?
Well, there is manipulation, and I think manipulation is wrong, meaning I'm trying to manipulate this situation. And so here's an example of manipulation. One of the houses that we looked at, we just put an offer in on. Brand new kitchen, been remodeled. It's an older home. And we went into it, and from the surface, it looks great. And so that's what kind of attracted us to it. We were like, all right, they did a remodel. I, from being a contractor, know that they cut some corners because in a remodel situation, you start making decisions. Opportunity now to open this wall up and fix all this stuff. And if you don't have the money, you just have to say, no, we can't afford to do it. So you end up with junction boxes in certain locations. And, you know, it is what it is. If we're not going to replace, if you're not going to spend $2,000 to do a sub panel, we're limited to what we can do, but there's still a right way to do it.
Yeah.
So we went in, had the inspector come in, and sure enough, all the stuff came up. They made galvanized to copper connections without the proper separation, which told me they were lazy, right?
Yeah.
So they sold this person a remodeled kitchen in this older home, and they manipulated the situation, making her think she was getting, because the kitchen looks great. It looks great. But now that she's got to spend even more, she should have spent another $20,000 to do all of the other stuff. There's lazy electrical work and all of that kind of stuff. That to me is manipulation. Yeah. The fact that our brains are wired to buy based on emotions, and if you understand that, and you, as long as you're not lying, saying this is a problem for you, we can solve this problem and give you this benefit, and here's how we're going to do it, is not manipulation. It's just good sales. So the question of, here's how I deal with the morality, because you can use that to manipulate people and take advantage of them. But you're a guy that believes 110% in the product and the service that you provide. Much so that your first question was concerned about safety of your employees. You're not gonna cut corners when it comes to that. You're that type of person. You need every weapon in your arsenal. And if that means I know I can get this person to spend more money with me than they would with somebody else, because I've got a superior product, I've got a superior service, I say that's not manipulation, that's obligation. You're obligated to sell to that person in a way that gives them the best service, the best quality, and the best product that you 100% believe in. I know you believe in your product, so that way you're actually obligated to do that for somebody, because there are other people out there that aren't as good as you, that will cut corners, that are in it just for the money. They will try to sell them the same product and service, but they're not giving it to them. So you're obligated as a professional craftsman to make sure that you're your customers buy from you and not from anybody else, because you don't
almost
know.
What like you're obligated. You feel obligated to protect them.
That's right. That's what I say. That's why I do what I do. I have to convince contractors that are cash strapped to give me a lot of money because I believe in what I'm doing. I am obligated to help you turn your business around, make more money. There's a cost that comes with that. But I believe that if you don't spend money with me, you may waste money on somebody else. So I'm going to set things up so that you and I can work together. And hopefully, if I don't return the results for my clients and don't help them out, then I'll be out of business. I'm willing to take that risk.
This may sound weird, but I've never thought about it like that before.
Yeah, well, think about it. Like, it'll change your perspective, man. That's definitely good. I hope that's a good thing, not like a bad thing.
Well, it's actually weird. It's like I had a release, good. You know, of something. I mean, it's just because, like I said, I feel it's weird. Like I said, it's like you feel guilty if you don't make money. You feel guilty if you make too much money, and so. It's almost like maybe that's gone.
Good.
I hope that changes the way that you look at selling your construction services. You are obligated to sell your services for the highest prices possible. Make a profit producing your work, then creating a great life for yourself, your employees, your customers, and your community. You can't do any of that without selling your work at the right price to the right customers. If you want to learn more about the program that Dustin was in and the other programs at the Built to Build Academy, go to builttobuildacademy.com and get on our waiting list. We'll be opening new programs in March.